This video is gonna be quite emotional. Let's get to it. How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? It's FamKam. Welcome to another edition of Weekly ASMR. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to click subscribe. And welcome to the fam. For those who don't know what Weekly ASMR is, a part of a collaborative group of ASMRists where each of put out a video each week regarding a specific topic. This week's topic is childhood memories. And I have a lot of great childhood memories and a handful of not so great childhood memories that I will be talking about on this channel in the future. But this memory in particular is so special that I'm going to be starting with this one as part of Weekly ASMR. And the other ones won't necessarily be a part of Weekly ASMR. This is so special because it's all about my maternal grandfather, Larry. Now, a little premise. My grandpa Larry was a huge, huge hero of mine who shaped me into the man I am today. Even though he was only there for a very, very, very short portion of my life. I was 6 going on 7 when he passed away. So you can imagine how much impact he had on me, considering how short of a time it was. Start from when I was really little, perhaps too young to remember. For the first few years of my life, when I was too young to remember things, my family and I lived in a 2-story house. I'm not gonna give any specific locations in this video, but we lived in a 2-story house. Much of that house, but I remember loving that house, and I remember being bummed out I couldn't see him very often in that collection because almost every single time he was there during a home video recording, he was the one holding the camera. But I remember seeing him sit in the corner when I was 3 years old. Christmas of that year, sat by as I was dunking basketballs in a little kiddie hoop inside, and 3 year old me was saying, "I'm playing basketball, I'm playing basketball." Shouldn't flop them because that can ruin. now that I own my own technology, I very much understand the seriousness of that. The ball and pans from left to right. which means Charlie Brown is slowly moving off screen like this in a pose where he's just standing on one leg. And of course, because it's an older computer, the frame rate was so low, so it's like bum 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 bum. So what I did is when I went bowling for real the first time, I rolled the ball, and as I was on one foot, I hopped backwards away from the lane after rolling. I was like, oh my god, I can't believe I did that. So back to things my grandpa taught me. When I was 5 or 6, he taught me how to play chess. And when he introduced the game to me, I was a little confused because I knew checkers, of course. And I thought he was messing with me. It's like, this is checkers. Are you making this up? It's like, no. Chess is a real game, and to this day, it is my favorite board game of all time. In fact, I played it on this channel on my 3-year relaxing PC games video. I'll have a link to that below in the description. Chess Ultra was one of the games. And, spoiler alert, despite the fact that I kind of played poorly in that video, I swear I'm usually a lot better than I played in that video. So I've been playing that game since I was like 5. But I'm nowhere near being the best chess player out there. But he taught me how to play, and if you play chess, you know that the knight has a very interesting way to move. Has its own rules for how it moves. The rook only goes forwards, backwards, and sideways. The bishop only goes diagonally. The queen can move any direction as far as she wants until she runs into something, of course. The king can move any direction but can only move one square. It's capturing another piece, then it's capturing diagonally. Sorry if I put you in a trance, although I guess I'm trying to put you in a trance. This is an ASMR video. But the knight, the horse-shaped piece, the knight, moves 2 spaces in one direction, forward, backward, or sideways, not diagonally. It moves 2 spaces and then moves to the side 1 space relative to the way it was moving before. My grandpa had a term for that. He called it 1-2-boom. 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 So if you have kids or planning on having kids someday, teach him how to play chess. Tell him the knight moves 1-2-boom. It's a pretty memorable way of thinking. Very effective. Like I said before, he had 5 computers. He had 5 PCs. He didn't have any computers running Windows. They were all computers that you just plug in or put in a disk, a floppy disk, turn the computer on, and it would run whatever disk you put in. Much like putting a cartridge in a game console back in the day. So for the Apple II, black put the disc in and powered it on, it actually colorized the game. It might have been a different computer, I'm not sure, but basically we were able to play those games in full color, which is really cool. Playing Charlie, typing as a bald Charlie Brown on that color screen. Out. Some days it was all the way up to their deck in the backyard. I don't think it ever flooded, but came close a couple times, I'm sure of that. And it also went so shallow that a couple times when I swam in it, my foot touched the bottom and got punctured by some sharp particles. I was okay though, fortunately. He also had a couple trees in the backyard that he built a little zip line between them. And I would just climb up the ladder and ride down that zip line over and over and over. And then when I was done, I would go to their little garden right by it and pick some apricots. And he used to say, if you wait too long, it's rotten. That never left my memories. I'll always forget that simple. Those simple little words of wisdom from him. If you wait too long, it's rotten. It doesn't just apply to food, that applies to pretty much everything in life. You don't want to wait. You do want to wait until a good opportunity arises. There is such thing as doing something too soon when it's not ripe yet. But you also got to trust your gut. If your gut tells you that it's the right time, probably is. Don't tell yourself otherwise. Don't tell yourself, well, it could be even better later. No. That's what I did with this ASMR channel. I started this ASMR channel months and months later than when I originally planned it. But it's not like starting it later benefited me. Going off on another tangent. He also had Pong, which, even though I've said before that Super Mario World for the Super Nintendo is what made me a gamer, my first experience with home gaming was Pong. The old school Pong with the dial controllers, where you turn a dial to move the paddle up and down. And on that system, 15 was the end of the game. I know I told the story before, but I'll tell it again in case you haven't seen my controller sounds video. But basically, he won every single match I played with them, except unbeatable. Maybe he's where I get my gamer genes. Just kidding, I don't think there's such a thing. It's something you learn to enjoy. It's something you learn to get good at. So my grandparents and my parents lived in different towns. And at that time, I spent a large portion of my time with my grandparents because my parents were working a lot and they weren't neglectful. It's not like they didn't prioritize me. They were actually super attentive, and I've always had a school, and we played a little game. You know, those sidewalks with little squares, big square tiles, not little, but you probably played the game don't step on the crack or you break your mother's back, kind of like that thing. Well, we played an even more difficult version. Well, more difficult if you're a kid. As an adult, I sometimes go back to that area and play that game again. And because I'm much bigger now, it's a lot easier. But because I was a small child and stuff, what we did was don't step in the same square. So you had to step 1 foot in each square. Basically, running, but slow running, power walking. I don't know. I come to find that the real difference between running and walking is when you're running, between each step, there's a point where both feet are on the off the ground at the same time. Whereas if you're walking, at least 1 foot is on the ground at all times. So sometimes I was power walking, and it was difficult because I was, again, really, really small. I was in kindergarten. And we also played a little game where 21 was my favorite number at the time for some reason, and he suggested that we head out of the house and head to school at 8:20 originally. And I loved the number 21 so much, I was like, no, let's leave at 8:21. He agreed that we can make it there in 9 minutes. You could actually make it there well under 9 minutes from that house. But on any day that I was ready to go before 8:21, we would just spend a few minutes just standing there staring at the clock, and when the clock struck 8:21, that's when we'd get out of the house and head to school. It's so funny to look at that now. He also had a fruit dehydrating machine. Slices and banana slices to make banana chips. And I used to bring them for show and tell. And when I brought banana chips, none of my classmates took any. Not a lot of kids like bananas. Sadly, my grandpa started to feel ill. I was always upbeat and hyper and wanted to get him to play. And he started telling me that he didn't feel like it, and I didn't understand why. And my grandma told me to leave him alone because he was not feeling well. I felt bad. I mean, I knew he was sick, but I had no idea how bad it was. It turned out that parents' house, my mom, my sister, and I were sitting on the nice warm carpet when my mom broke the news to us. She didn't even dance around the subject. She was very straightforward. My mom's always been very open and honest and very, very straightforward. Short-lived, very good childhood memory of mine. And anytime I'm feeling like I'm not myself, I need to remember who I am, as Mufasa puts it in The Lion King. I often think back to my grandpa. If not the biggest reason why I am who I am. He is the number one reason, without a doubt, why I am such a health nut. He was just a couple weeks shy, or a week shy, of turning 60 when he passed. All the way back in 1994. Almost a quarter century ago. This July, it will have been a quarter century since he passed away. Still with you in some way or form. And I'm not even talking about dying and going to heaven or reincarnating or what have you. I'm not talking about anything religious or anything like that. It's far beyond that. What you believe religiously is your business and your business only, just like mine are my business and my business only. As cliche as it is, he still is in my heart forever and ever. And his passing, the most important lesson I learned from his passing, is a lesson that we all know, but we tend to take for granted. That is, life is precious. Cherish every moment of it. Never, ever, ever turn the other cheek on your life. that's why the health nut, and that's why I don't deal with death very well at all. I can't stand seeing animals die or people dying. I still to this day have never in my life witnessed a person or an animal dying. I have squashed a few bugs when I was younger, I will admit that. But I wouldn't do that today. I'm now one of those people that literally wouldn't hurt a fly. I just couldn't take it. Some may say I'm soft, and maybe they're right, but I have a soft heart, but a strong soul. So bad.